Welcome all. Today we will discuss three tools to like wrapper from gcove tools, open CPP coverage for Windows and integration codecove with GitLab. What is gcove? Gcove is GDC tools that use for checking cover coverage. need add option coverage all profile args test coverage if you use all version GDC. After it compile code, during compilation will be generate GC and all file. It contains some information about source code, then run test of your application. During test will be generate GCNDA files that have information about execution, what exactly was executed, or some additional information. First tool is lcove. It is a front-end from gcove tools. How it works? Need add flag that I mentioned in previous slides, and compile and run test. After it, run lcove and generate HTML report. You can find some example in lcove reports from LibreOffice by link. And now see simple example is just calculator with the for function plus minus multiplication and division. It's very simple example and some test. Test very simple. I use it Google test framework and test. In this case, tests for function plus minus multiplication and division. Our project have this structure. We have gtest frame library, our lib folder with header and CPP file, and some test project where we execute RTUst and main function. And I use CMake and add some flags for CMake. First, I disable optimization and add coverage for compiler and for linker. Make build using CMake. It's very simple. And run ctest. We see that test passed, and we can find new file gcda and make report using lcove. We set directory where located files gcda and output file, and then make HTML report from output file. Its name call info, and you can see how console. And if you use Clang, you should use some wrapper because Clang use some different formats, and you just need add option lcove tools and some bash file when convert what format to GTC.
And sorry,
can you repeat the question, because I hear a lot of noise. Okay. Oh, if you have question, you can ask me during presentation or after presentation. So it's HTML report, and we see a lot of files that not unuseful some system files, and how to filter. We can remove some files like system include and Google test framework and generate new output file and regenerate report. So now report use look more readable. We see just point directory, our library, our test. And we can check what wasn't coverage by our test. And we see that throw exception was at coverage for our test. So we don't check second parameter of division. but sometimes we need ignore some lines during test coverage. For example, it can be like some unimplemented function of something codes that will refactor in the future. We can use some execution markers, lcove x start and lcove x stop. And in report, this part of code will be ignored in test code coverage. When how to install lcove? Of course, you can use sudo apt install lcove. But I recommend to use Git because Git have more newest version than from app repository. If you have error like version of file is not good, it means like when you install, you should check your default GDC compiler and compiler that was used for compile this code. If you error with JSON, just run sudo cpn JSON. And if you have warning during generate output file like overlong record at the end of file, it was bug in lcove when you use GDC 9. Just update to 1.14. Next tools is gcove. It is also like front end for gcove, but it's most familiar if you use coverage for Python. And you can installation is very easy, just pip install or install from Git. And how you use its tools? It's very simple, like previous tools. We built our project, run all tests, and run just gcove with arith, which means include all subfiles and just file for. And second argument is file with our source code. And you can see like this report in console. And there we have also some files that we want to ignore. This means Google test library, just add execute gtest, and now report is more readable. And generate HTML report. It's pretty similar to lcove, but the default, the default HTML report doesn't contain source of file. If we want to include source of file, we should generate HTML detailed report. And we can, and it looks like similar, and we can see what function, what line of code wasn't covered by test. GCrow have other formats like XML, JSON, and for some plugins that can be used for in Nginx and in other tools. Now move tools for Windows. For Windows is OpenCPP coverage. It's open source tools, and you can use plugin for Visual Studio. But I tested for CMake files in Visual Studio. I use last version, it's 2019. And for CMake files, this plugin doesn't work because I just open CMake list .txt file. Maybe if I open solution, this plugin will be work, but you can just run like application without Visual Studio. Just set directory with source and run our exe file with our test. And you can see some part of console. And HTML report look like it. And we also see a lot of files that is not uncovered because we use Google test framework and we don't want to check coverage this test. We we just execute our gtest. And one moment, when you set some directory, you should use absolute path. This is some limits of these tools. And you can see our tools. You see that execution marks doesn't work for it. These tools ignore these execution marks. I tried to find some other marks for these tools, but I just find that we can ignore some lines using crack-exp. And these tools have other formats like HTML, some format for Kubertura plugin for Nginx, and binary file. Binary file, it's similar to output files that we use in Alcove, where you can merge some coverage, remove some files, edit, and other action with these files. Next tools, it's Codecov. It's like integration with your continuing integration system. I use GitLab and use same example. How to integrate Codecov with GitLab? First of all, you should get token. It's pretty simple. Just open your settings in this site and copy your token. You can use token like environment variable or add in Codecov file. I use environment variable and just put this token in GitLab. It's also pretty simple. Open settings and put variable. And it is GitLab file. Short introduction for this file. Just use GTC Docker image. Run update, install CMake, build project, run ctest, and after when it's finished, run some bash script from Codecov. And if you need customize Codecov, just add this file and set ignore some folder if you know of, you can use other settings. And when you make some commit, run just run your build, you will see in console like this, and you see that you see a report by link. And and if your commit reduce your code coverage, you will see some like regression of diff between commits. In this example, I just remove execution marks, and you will see that code coverage will reduce by 7%. No, it's very convenient tools. So we review LCOV tools, GCROV tools, some tools for Windows, and integration with GitLab. As for me, I prefer to use GCROV because it's pretty easy, and it's easier parts output in console, just use regex. Integration with your continue integration system is pretty good too, because you will see which commit decrease your code coverage. But other things, 100% coverage, it not means that all logic is coverage by test. It just shows that all lines was called during your execution, like test of your application. So that's all. Do you have any question? So I think if you don't have any question, thank you for your time.